Halo, selamat datang kembali di Rich Speak episode terbaru ya. Kali ini di season terbarunya kita bakal ngobrol sama vokalis band indie rock, indie punk, atau emo, atau apapun itu ya. Tapi dia emang salah satu sosok yang dikagumi di era sekarang untuk genre musik itu. Dan pastinya kalau kamu ngikutin bandnya dia dari album Spin mungkin ya, atau album awalnya yang self-title yang covernya pizza, pasti tahu siapa dia. Dan ini dia, Ben Wallace from Tiger's Joe. Hi Ben.
Hey, Robert, how's it going?
I'm doing good. Did I pronounce it right? Walsh, Ben Walsh, is it right?
That's correct.
Okay.
That's it.
I'm so glad for doing it because sometimes people in here do get that really wrong, like Ben Walsh or like Welsh, you know.
Hey, you nailed it. It was perfect.
All right. So, first thing first, you know, I want to ask you something really, really quick, and maybe it's quite detailed about this thing, you know, because some people are actually wondering about it. Mm-hmm. So, how successful Biotin Dry Mouth Spray is for preventing dry mouth?
How successful is what?
Yeah, the Biotin Dry Mouth Spray.
Oh, Biotin.
Yeah.
It's great. So that's my hidden secret for performing live. When I have to sing for an hour straight, you know, it helps my throat to feel moisturized and it helps my voice to feel smooth, I guess. So mm-hmm. I use that. I keep it on my amp during shows. And if I start to feel a little bit scratchy from singing, I'll just go and spray it a little bit. So it works great for me.
So it's officially recommended by Ben Walsh, right? People should try that.
Officially recommended. I'll give it two thumbs
all
up.
Right.
It helps me a lot. It gives me peace of mind. Like if I'm worried that I always get worried that I'm going to lose my voice during a show. So that is like sort of something I can rely on to help myself out.
That's all right. That's cool. Okay, so let's move to your song. So I just checked out your new songs like Warn Me and then Cat's Cradle from the new record and then the new one, New Detroit, right? So
yeah.
I just checked out the comment sections on YouTube, and some people mentioned Gin Blossoms on your comment section. What's this connection between Gin Blossoms and Tiger's Joe? Do you like? Was it really intentional when you put that reference to your music, or like, I would just do that?
Well, I've always loved like alternative rock and you know, like '90s rock. I love the Gin Blossoms. You know, I have a soft spot for those bands. You know, when I first started becoming aware of rock music, it was whatever was on the radio. So the Gin Blossoms and, you know, the Goo Goo Dolls and Third Eye Blind and bands like that, you know, around the year 2000, those were playing on the radio. So I really have a soft spot for those sort of bands. So it's definitely possible that they've influenced my songwriting.
That's cool. Okay, move on. So, how was the Atlantic Record experience before you moved to Hopeless? So, what's the reason you're moving to Hopeless?
So, the experience with Atlantic was very interesting, and we learned a lot about how major labels work. And it was like we mostly dealt with only a few people, so it felt like a small team. But because it was part of a major label, things move a little bit more slowly, just because there's so many people that have to sign off on every single decision. So it felt like everything was a little bit behind because there had to be so many people involved apart from just our team. So with Hopeless, it's a small team. And everybody has their role and everybody does it really well. And it's like, it feels like an independent label because, you know, it is an independent label, but they have the strength and the influence of a major label. So it's just there. I feel like maybe they're more efficient. We did have a very good experience with the team that we worked with at Atlantic. But I guess it wasn't the right fit or something because they did it end up dropping us. And so when we recorded this most recent album, we were like, well, we're free agents now. We can go anywhere. And we were friendly with Hopeless, and we started talking to them about working together and realized that we would make a good team. So we signed with them. We're really excited about it.
That's cool. So was there any other record label before Hopeless that approached you?
We definitely talked to a few labels. I don't know I don't know if it's not a good thing to mention them by name, but we had a couple of options, and it's always a difficult decision because you're trusting your very personal art to somebody else to work on. And we had a really great feeling about the team at Hopeless. They showed us that they cared so much about what we thought, and they gave us a lot of creative freedom to make things the way that we want to make them. So it's a good partnership.
That's cool. Okay, so Cat's Cradle, I think that's probably like the new single that I really like the most, you know, like it's a big
awesome.
It's a big leap from your so-called emo sound or like indie rock sound, you know. It sounds really like, you know, I think I can safe to say like it's like Ozma but a little bit more emotional, I guess. Ozma core, like Ozma-esque, you know. So does that song, like the big leap, the change of sound, does that have anything to do with Will Yip being on board on the record?
I think that there's definitely a few things that influenced how this new record sounded. Will Yip is a huge part of that. We've done a few records with him, and each time we try to do something differently, and we have different goals that we want to accomplish. For this record, it was myself and Brianna, but also Colin Gorman on bass and Teddy Roberts on drums. So it was the first time as a full four-piece band, we all approached the record together. And those guys have been playing in the band for like 5 or 6 years at the point when we started recording. So we've played so many shows together. We've really gotten to know each other as musicians, as people, and there's a lot of trust in each other. So what we wanted to do most with this record was replicate the energy of our live shows. So we communicated that to Will, and we said we want these recordings to be big and energetic and a little bit raw, and he did a really, really great job bringing it to life.
It actually really delivers, because Cat's Cradle is great.
Thank you very much.
Okay, moving on. So I read somewhere about Chris Conley said that he loves your band and your album. I guess I read that somewhere. And of course, you have that love for In Reverie, their album, right?
Absolutely. It's my favorite record.
Yeah, is there any plan to collaborate with him?
Not specifically, but I did get to meet him finally after all these years. I finally got to meet him. We played a festival in England in 2019, and we played on the same stage, and so we were just like watching all the bands all day together, and we hung out and kind of just told each other that we were big fans of each other's work, and it would be great to collaborate with them in some way, or maybe even go on tour together sometime. That would be really cool for me, because their music and specifically that record has meant so much to me.
That's awesome. If it really happens, I'm looking forward for that.
Me too.
Okay, so this is the interesting part of this interview. We always do this kind of some kind of like pop quiz for all our guests in this interview. So
okay.
Here's the playing rule. So you have to pick one of the two options and then tell me the reason behind it. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. Pop quiz with Ben Welsh from Tiger Show. There we go. Number one, thick or thin crust pizza?
Ooh, I like thick crust pizza. And the why? I think that I like it to be filling. You know, I love bread and I love cheese. So thick crust, lots of cheese, and that's a good pizza for me.
Fair enough. Okay, number two, Blue Album or Pinkerton?
Blue Album.
Oh.
I love Pinkerton for its energy and I love the production on it, but the songwriting on Blue Album is perfect. It's so good.
That's true. The last one, Through Being Cool or Can't Slow Down? I know In Reverie is your favorite album, but you have to pick one.
Through Being Cool, I think. I think the first time I ever heard Saves the Day was that record. So I have a nostalgic connection to it. So I think I would have to go with Through Being Cool.
Fair enough. Thank you for playing, Ben Walsh from Tiger's Jaw. Okay, Ben, thank you for your time. I'm really grateful for you talking to me right here. And I can really wait for I Won't Care How You Remember Me, right? When will be out? Tell us.
It's out on March 5th. So less than a month from today. I don't know when this will air, but March 5th is the release date.
Okay, I'll make sure to ask Edwin from Hopeless Record, who set up this interview, to get the record from him. That's cool. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, have him send it over.
Yeah, thank you once again, Ben. Dan inilah Rich Speak.